The purpose there is not to realistically abort the epidemic, although that would be the goal, but it's more to delay it. And in the process, what delay does is it buys you time. And what time does is it allows you to implement or roll out your emergency preparedness plan, right? And so every hospital, every clinic, every institution that takes care of patients have now the luxury of time to prepare for this. Do they have placement strategies for patients? Do they have personnel? Do they have personal protective equipment? Do we have the equipment, the materials necessary to take care of these patients? So this is what time buys us. And the other thing that time buys us is by decreasing the number of severe cases, but nonetheless, accepting the fact that there will be some transmission, in an epidemiological curve, what happens is that there becomes more and more people who not only become infected, but they recover. And then those recover people make it less easy for the virus to circulate. Fortunately, children don't seem to be very sick when they get the coronavirus, including the COVID-19, but they do risk spreading it. As anybody who has had a kid in daycare or elementary school, we know that respiratory viruses are easily transmitted. And so that, by closing schools even temporarily, it does minimize a hub of viral transmission. The rationale behind that is because within a mass gather, there could be two kinds of individuals, right? One who is able to spread the virus, whether or not they have symptoms, and others who may be susceptible to severe disease should they catch the virus. And so the principle behind dispersal or minimization of mass gatherings is to prevent those two individuals from being in contact. We have to be a little bit cautious when we go into public areas, cognizant of the fact that there is COVID and perhaps other bugs that we could easily catch. And so when there's an opportunity to wash your hands, you do it. When there's an opportunity to minimize behaviors that can transmit, for example, the coughing or the sneezing onto other people, that needs to be everybody's responsibility. The data is fluid, but what we know so far is that the majority of the severe cases have been people who are elderly and people who have chronic heart and lung conditions. And so if you have those types of people in your family, it really behooves you to make sure that you minimize contact with them if you are potentially at risk. So that means that if you've traveled to areas where there's a COVID that's epidemic, or if you have symptoms of a respiratory tract infection, then you perhaps should not go visit grandmother this weekend. You should try to make sure you still can check in on them, and that can be in our age through the internet. But you should try to make sure that those measures, the contact measures, are minimized. And if, in the event that their contact is necessary, again, meticulous care for hand washing and using all measures to minimize transmission, like the hygiene measures.